It's a Thursday, and for some beautiful reason, I want to throw back. Now, for all of you who grew up in the 90s, right? There were certain things that, in the musical culture, that we all fell in love with. One, checkered shirts and Chuck Taylors. Ooh, we used to call Chuck Taylors Businupu Dogo. Ooh, I'm going back to the days of Wu-Tang Clan, KRS-One, Jodeci, New Edition, like all that good music. That's what I'm throwing back to. Good Lord, I feel nostalgic already. Anywho, my name is Tinafia Swan and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. So Lydia Jasmine is down in the south of Africa. Yes, child. How do we know she's somewhere? She takes a naked photo all the time. Like Lydia. Before I can even get to talk about what you're doing in SA, do you know that Lydia Jasmine has officially replaced Helen Lukoma in the business of just giving us naked photos of like, I have a body. At every given point, Lydia Jasmine, I'm like, you know what? Trick! Yes, you look good. You have a fine body. Now cover the fuck up. Cover up! We are tired. We are like so tired. Like every time I see a photo of this girl, she's gonna be up on some. It's like you're the new age Kardashian, only you're in Africa that doesn't really care. Really doesn't care. And for all the times you throw your body at us, the only thing men will say, they're like, damn, she fine. The only thing ladies are going to say is like, damn, she fine. And that's it. We forget you after saying she fine. You know what? Because you've concentrated on selling your body more than you have decided to sell your talent. I don't know if you get it. Like, who told you you cannot be famous if you don't show your body parts? Who told you? Where is it written? I want someone to give me where it's written that if a chick don't take photos nude, if a chick don't show she has curves, if a chick don't show enough skin, just point me in that direction that she won't be anything. I'm trying to understand this ish. And you know what pisses me off about this is that we get pissed off when men objectify us as ladies, right? We get very mad that, oh my goodness, they're objectifying, then the feminists stand up and then it all goes to hell, gender wars break out. But you know why they objectify us? They learn from the best. They learn from us because it's all we have given them. We have turned ourselves into objects and we're just there to be admired. And then when they come and then objectify us, they're like, oh my goodness, men are trash. You're the women. I was thinking about this the other day and I was telling people, when will I go on my timeline and I don't see a naked woman? When will I go on any timeline and not see a naked Kardashian? When will I go on any timeline and not see Lydia Jasmine but naked? When? Okay, she's not entirely naked, but of course she's always serving. Like, when? We are the reason we keep saying men are trash. And that, in all honesty, I don't think there is a problem with men. The problem is with us, and they're just getting the vibe from us. And then we hate ourselves so much for actually knowing it, we decide to reverb, you know? We're like, no, it's the men. Girl, sis, put some clothes on. Your heifers out here in the cold, in the winter, in the summertime, you're always, always naked. You're going to catch cases of bodies. You're going to catch weird diseases. All because you're trying to be a thought. All because you're trying to thirst trap Lydia Jasmine. If I were you, I will humble down. Because now we know you have a body. We knew you had a body from the jump. We knew it. We knew it. And we don't really care because what brought you was not the body. If you wanted us to just admire your body and make sure that is what we know you for, girl, hit the runway somewhere, become an IG model, one of them things. But you came to us with your music. Now you can sing, Trick. You can sing. But this cheap popularity, Joelico, I don't know. You think when men keep seeing you naked, they are going to like your music anymore? I'm sorry, girlfriend, I had news. You could strip down to the bare minimum and Ugandans will still not want your music. Now, for me, this is what I'm saying. Dress up, cover your body, open your mind. How's that? Cover your body and dress your mind. Be much more talented, be more daring, be more all these things. I'm tired. And someone is going to be like, you know what? This is a sister putting a sister down. No, this is a sister putting you in check because the sisters you have around you clearly don't want to tell you the truth. Dress up, girlfriend. Dress up, keep your legs together, go hit the studio and keep looking for that one song that's gonna make you a star. Anyway, what was the story about? Oh yeah. She's down in South Africa shooting a new, she's shooting a video for her new song with that South African guy called Face Off. But even what's funny as much as she's innocent, I have not yet seen. I thought I would see photos of her in studio or on set, you know? Mm-mm. She first took off her clothes just to show us I'm in SA at the beach and I'm naked, tricks. I'm like, girl, cover up, child. Whew. Is that famous say, that famous song? We don't have to take her clothes off. Think about that. Just think about it. Good Lord, this Ugandan heifers. So, Jackie Chandiru is back with a bang. Aren't we all excited? Yeah, are we all happy? Most definitely. Nobody wanted to see her sink and sink and sink and sink until we're going to put her 6 feet under. So yes, I'm happy she came out. She's been trying to talk about her, you know, past situation, what she went through, and she's now trying to keep positive vibes. She's back in studio. She's going to be headlining. She's actually started headlining a couple of performances, and now she's actually going to be at the Awilo Longomba concert. I was like, good for you, but here's the twist though. It's going to be her and Cindy on the same lineup. I'm finna know. Who's going to come out and say something? Like, will it be Cindy? Is Cindy going to come out and go like, ah, oh, my sister, come, let's get a hug and do that reunion we always talked about. I'm waiting for that reunion. You told us. And these were the words of Cindy. Cindy, every time they would ask her about her situation with Blue 3 and the girls, she's like, you know what? I'm so over it right now. Like, I can't. I'm cool with them. Like, I mean, if they reached out to me, I would definitely, you know, I'm down for a reunion. So what's happening? Jackie's out of depression. Lillian is still going through it, but we can't blame her. She just lost a baby father. She has kids. So let's wait for Lillian to get it together. And then let's see if you two can, if all three of you can come together. Because let me tell you, this is one thing I know for a fact. You are like the charmed sisters. Now, most people may not say this, but you are like the charmed sisters. The power of three, right? All of you broke out. Almost each of you got the same amount of fame. And then it just died out. But together, the magic could be there. Because think about it. Cindy, when she broke up, yeah, she got this whole nice career. Hey, we made so much noise. We know her. Yes, we know her. She drops a song, we sing to it. But it's just like she failed to reach that peak. You know, like the Sheba peak, Jaliko, the Irene Talley peak, that peak. She's a great artist. She's a good performer. Now, let's move on. Jackie Chandiru tried. We listened to her music. We loved it in her language. It was a different style. No, it was beautiful, deep, rich, sensational. Yeah, and then she also got to a point where it just went like, it maintained, and then all that happened. Cindy also, all that happened. You got to a white man, ended up having bitter issues. Then we have Lillian, the powerhouse, the girl with the voice that makes the hairs of my neck stand up when she really wants to sing. That girl, it was there, then it was not there. Then Moze tried to put it there again. And then you're like, nah, you know. Then you decided to go and do live band. And then we went back to you being a cover artist. I was disappointed in Lillian. Because I like to say, that girl's voice, Jesus, that's, Like I see her doing something with, what's that guy's name, Michael Chiwanuka. I see Lillian and Michael Chiwanuka. On a good, y'all are disappointments apart from each other. So why don't you put the pertinence aside? Y'all was young. None of you knew what to do and how to deal with being celebrity. Put that ish aside. Get back in studio with none other than Steve Jean because he knows your chemistry. Let's make some money, ladies. Let's secure some bags. Put the pertinence aside. Y'all need each other. These heifers. Anyway, but I'll be so here for the reunion. I would so be here for it. Because then I would love to dance to Hitaji. That's a dope song. Maybe I'll also try to rap to Navio's verses and Burn. The song was called Burn, but it was pronounced as Burn. That'll be fun. Good times. Oh yeah, before I say bye-bye, guess what? This whole who is stealing radio's music, who is doing what, Katichaga, Video Nagamba, Mbu, Ntino, Radio, had all his recent music stored on his phone. Now, whoever has that phone is the person releasing radio's music. And he goes on to shed some light on that and is like, Mubuze Wizo, anaya sigaza simu ya radio. I don't know if it's the one who has it, but Mumubuze. I'm like, yo, first of all, that's dumb. I met radio you know radio. Yes, he would put a few tracks of his on the phone, but he always had one flash drive. I remember there were like about 3 flash drives. That was 2 months before he passed on, and he told me personally, he's like, my entire life's work is on these 3 flash drives. So how does somebody explain the phone situation? Whoever has the drives is the person selling them. That's simple. I'm just so tired. Why did it get this messy? Why? Can't we just let the man rest in peace? Ugh. Anyway. That's been my time, people. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop. And at TinaFierce1, like, follow the pages. And on Instagram, it's at TinaFierce1 with an H. I'm out. Catch you tomorrow when it's going to be a Friday. Ooh-wee, ooh-wee. I'm out. Peace.